setting a scene so important to a rivalry, it's been named the Civil War. Welcome to FS1 College Football, presented by K Jewelers. Today's Pac-12 matchup featuring the Oregon State Beavers visiting the Oregon Ducks here at Autzen Stadium in Eugene, Oregon. With former Stanford receiver Evan Moore, I am Chris Myers, and hope you enjoying your Thanksgiving holiday. I know you're going to enjoy Vernon Adams today, Evan, unless you're a member of the defense. He is a seed coming off a 6-touchdown performance. The team, the Ducks, have won 5 straight, averaging 43 points a game during that stretch. And this is a guy, Vernon Adams, who brings entertainment value to every game.
Well, there's no question. Vernon Adams has absolutely caught fire the last 5 weeks since he's been healthy, to the tune of 1,500 yards, 18 touchdowns, and 4 interceptions on a 5-game win streak. Played outstanding football since he's been back, and he's showing just how valuable he is. In addition, having him in the backfield with Royce Freeman, the Pac-12 freshman of the year last year, had just over 1,300 yards. This year, just under 1,600 yards as he chases the Pac-12 rushing title alongside Christian McCaffrey from Stanford. Both of those guys will be significant weapons for him today in this rivalry game.
A lot to deal with for the Oregon State defense. Meanwhile, their head coach, Gary Anderson, in his first year, he's had to deal with a lot of injury. Young players, only 11 seniors active on this team. Starting his third different freshman quarterback today, he's from California, Marcus McMarion.
Well, the decision to go with Marcus is largely a microcosm of what this team has dealt with all year long: youth and injuries. But Marcus showed enough last week against the University of Washington to warrant his first start today, and it's going to be important for them to get him into rhythm. And by doing that, you got to find guys like Victor Bolden and Jordan Villeman, two very capable receivers for this Oregon State offense, and it's important for them to step up and take some of the load off of this redshirt freshman and allow this team to move the ball here in a hostile environment.
And it is hostile. This rivalry goes back to 1894. This is the 119th meeting today, and whatever the score of the standings, the emotions always run high in the Civil War. Oregon State won the toss and wanted the football. 17th ranked Oregon kicking off in the shadows, and Victor Bolden will down it, so it is a touchback. And here comes the redshirt freshman from California, has seen some action, as Evan just talked about, in 6 games. His most extensive work coming last week against Washington, with 8 completions in 16 pass attempts for 109 yards, and had his first touchdown toss.
Yeah, it's going to be important for them in this environment to just get him reps, get him in rhythm. Very difficult place to play in an Oregon defense that has been surging the last few weeks. Expect them to bring pressure here early on, back in their own territory with a young guy under center.
Ryan Nall in the backfield, and he gets the carry up across the 32-yard line from Sandy, Oregon, and Central Catholic, one of those freshman players we've talked about, Evan, and one of those impact players today.
Yeah, they've been beaten up a little bit, the running back position. They're going to go with Ryan Nall today and rely on him to move that ball down the field and control the tempo of the game. Two big-time receivers in Victor Bolden and Jordan Villeman, but on defense for Oregon, DeForest Buckner. It's up to him to set the tempo up front like he's done consistently throughout the year. Was a big part of this Oregon defense.
We will see Seth Collins, some at quarterback, some at receiver, as Nall experiencing his first Civil War, the first of many, according to his coach, he hopes. And now Storm Bars Woods, who has been outstanding, has had nagging injuries all season long.
Yeah, one of the things we're seeing right now from this Oregon State offense is right now on the field, they're huddling. Not something they've done a ton of this year, but it's something they talked about throughout the course of the week. If we're going to control the tempo, there's no need for us to get up to the line in a no-huddle offense. They want to slow things down a little bit, and that starts with huddling before each play.
And try and play keep away from Vernon Adams and that Oregon offense. On 3rd and 3. McMarion looks to throw. Can he get the first down? Reaching across, DeForest Buckner making the stop right at what looks like the 35-yard line.
It looks like McMarion here wants to go to the boundary and throw a slant route. And one thing these young quarterbacks have all been able to do throughout the course of the season is be mobile. And once he loses number one, he tries to get the yards and extend for the first down, which it looks like they're going to give to him.
He did get it, Evan. So 1st and 10, Oregon State. And the coaching staff talked about how well McMarion, for a freshman, handled a lot of the ups and downs of the quarterback situation this year. and a number of injuries as well. Victor Bolden sets up in the backfield and now in motion to the bottom of your screen. McMarion with time fires and caught up across the 42. Jordan Villeman.
Just like we said in the open, getting Jordan Villeman out in space right here, going to get the slant route, delivers the ball right out of his break. A little late, and Charles Nelson getting there, making a good hit. But good job by Jordan Villeman hanging on to that football and getting yards for this Oregon State offense. The key here is rhythm throws for Marcus McMarion. You can see that's what they're trying to do, is get these rhythm throws.
Seth Collins checks in, takes the direct snap, and runs for the first down at across midfield. Collins, the freshman who has tried to play some quarterback. He was hurt his athletic ability. They talked about using him at receiver. We're going to see him all over the place.
Yeah, they talked about he really is the best athlete on this football team, they feel. A freshman that played some quarterback, led this team in rushing for most of the season. You're going to see him at receiver, wildcat, in the backfield, all over the place as they try to put on display his athletic ability.
Ryan Nall back in the backfield after an 8-yard pickup. And here's a little pitch to Seth Collins, who's going to throw the football, and catch made on the sideline by Victor Bolden.
We'll take a look at the feet here, but these are the exact kind of things that happen in rivalry games, these trick plays. A great ball out to Victor Bolden, and he looks like he gets that right foot in before he hits the ground, secures the catch. That's going to be a first down in Oregon territory.
44th catch of the year for Victor Bolden. He's been averaging 10 yards a grab. Has also run the ball, averaging over 5 a carry. A pickup of 21. Ryan Nall waiting for the direct snap. Marcus McMarion is back in, and Nall the handoff as he's thrown down inside the 3-yard line.
Oh, Chris. Gary Anderson deserves a lot of credit here, not only for electing to take the ball first, but being very creative on this first drive and realizing that so much of the tempo of this football game is on what they're able to do on this first drive. And they've answered the call, and they're knocking on this end zone right now with a chance to go up 7-0.
And Seth Collins is in at quarterback. He has the football, and he's got a touchdown, Oregon State. What an impressive opening drive for the Beavers here at Autzen Stadium.
Well, once again, Chris, using a number of different guys. On this replay, you'll see them bring Victor Bolden on a jet sweep to create a little bit of misdirection, allowing Seth Collins to get up the middle. You're going to see him in so many different capacities today. The best athlete on this team, and even though he had dealt with some injuries, he's back and he looks healthy as ever right now.
Garrett Owens with the extra point. Seth Collins, not the starting quarterback, but he runs in for his 6th touchdown of the season, and the Beavers have the early lead. A 75-yard drive. Collins, who had the touchdown run, also threw a pass on that drive, and Nall carried 4 different times. They're doing this without Storm Bars Woods, their leading rusher, who is not dressed for today.
Well, fittingly, in a game like this, they're going to leave no clubs in the bag. They've made it very clear on this first drive. They're going to pull out all the stops to put this ball in the end zone. And I love the way they've used Seth Collins here early on, given his athletic ability and how much he means to this offense.
Garrett Owens with the short kick, and it's Charles Nelson, and the ball comes out. Vernon Adams starting his 9th game for Oregon. The numbers impressive. Tried to play through an early finger injury. Once this team was 3-3, they have taken off now, winning 5 straight, ranked 17th in the country, and an offense that, Evan Moore, you talked about behind the way. You don't really stop Vernon Adams. You just try to redirect him, and here he hands off to Royce Freeman.
Fittingly, on the first play, they're going to look to run the football, and that brings us to our impact players. Royce Freeman, probably the most overlooked back in all of college football, just a dynamic player. Darren Carrington, a receiver, a guy that came back from suspension from the first part of this year. On the Oregon State side, Kyle Pecco is going to be big for them as they try to plug this Oregon running game.
Dwayne Stanford, 2nd on the team in catches, makes a grab, and it'll bring up 3rd down. See a little bit of the pushing and shoving.
Just a feature year in and year out of a rivalry game of this magnitude. Fun to watch.
On 3rd down and 2 from the Oregon 30. Freeman into the crowd.
This one's going to be close, and it's impressive to see the energy that these Beavers are coming out with today. Given the season they've had, it's clear this game means a lot to them. They get up and try to plug that hole that Royce Freeman tries to push through.
He got the first down.
They're going to give it to him. Royce, such a tough guy in short yardage situations. Sometimes in these spread offenses, we start to believe that maybe he's more of a scat back. He is a powerful 230-pound stud in the backfield, and he shows it right there.
Adams. Stanford has it up near midfield. The 48 of Oregon made it look easy.
Chris, you and I talked about all week, there's such a number of guys at this receiver position for Oregon. It's pick your poison for Vernon Adams. So many weapons on the outside to work with.
Mark Helfrich in his third season as Freeman goes toward the sideline and tries to get another Oregon first down.
On that one, we see a great example, too, of this wide receiving core and how important it is for them to get their perimeter blocking. On that one, Darren Carrington on the outside. You're going to see as he gets outside, Darren Carrington right there getting his block. It's what these receivers are asked to do every play.
Isn't the call if you don't block, you don't play?
That's
even
correct.
If you're a receiver. That's
Scott Frost, offensive coordinator, made that very clear. Those guys that don't block will not play because perimeter blocking is so key in this offense, and it's why they lead the Pac-12 in rushing year in and year out.
First down at the 42 of Oregon State, and Griffin is in at running back, the freshman. Adams open. It's Stanford again. His third catch on this drive, but he's still going. Inside the 20 of Oregon State.
Something that probably wasn't emphasized enough early this season is Vernon Adams' ability to be accurate and deliver the ball down the field. When he had a broken finger, I'm not sure that everyone realized how good of a passer he really is. And now that he's healthy, we're seeing that on full display.
And a quick snap as Carrington gets the football.
And almost on cue, another guy suspended for the early part of this season. And since he's come back, they've done extremely well getting him the ball. It's been very valuable to what they do. Communication is key on that Oregon State sideline with as quickly as this Oregon offense moves.
Freeman has, no, it's Braylon Addison, excuse me, running the other way. And Braylon Addison is in the end zone, and touchdown Oregon.
Just a great example of the versatility of this Oregon offense. The Oregon State defense reads this play well. They essentially shut it down, but can't account for the cutback. And Braylon Addison, probably the most versatile weapon on this Oregon offense. He can do so many different things. And when you get a guy that crosses field like that and puts it in the end zone and your defense is in the right place, it's very frustrating as a defensive coordinator.
His second rushing touchdown of this season from 13 yards out. Royce Freeman was in on the play, but it was Braylon Addison who got the carry, reversed field, and found the end zone for the Ducks. Tied here in the opening quarter, 6:49 to play. And that drive of 78 yards and under 3 minutes before the Addison touchdown run. And Vernon Adams was 3 out of 3, and they all went to Stanford.
Dwayne Stanford's role increased in the absence of Darren Carrington earlier this year. And even with Darren Carrington now back, he's shown that he's here to stay as far as making catches as called upon. And Mark Helfrich was very pleased with how well he catches the football.
From the end zone, it's Holden and brought down across the 17.5-yard line. And it's Seth Collins on the move across the 25 of Oregon State.
Just to give the fans an idea of how valuable Seth Collins is, over the course of this season, this Oregon State offense has averaged about 180 rushing yards a game. Just under 80 of those have been Seth Collins. Now, they don't necessarily want their quarterback to run that often, sometimes to the detriment of their passing game, but he's proven he's a weapon. There's no question about that.
Ryan Nall comes back in, but that was some of the frustration with Oregon State, is that they had people open. They just couldn't get them the football. One of the reasons they tried McMarion as the starter today. And McMarion's throw is intercepted. Midfield, it's a takeaway, and Charles Nelson, what's an offensive star, with the pickoff in the secondary.
Well, Charles Nelson, such a valuable guy on both sides of the ball. He's essentially playing center field here, and he's going to read the quarterback's eyes. And as a rookie mistake, McMarion stares down his receiver just a little too long and overthrows him. And Charles Nelson is there. And Chris, all week long, we talked about how valuable Charles Nelson is. He's such a great player. Frustrating the young guy, Marcus McMarion. Fortunately for this Oregon State team, we've heard plenty about McMarion's ability to bounce back from stuff like this when things don't go his way. That's why they decided to go with him today. It'll be important for him to shrug that off, because he's got to lead this offense several more times today to keep this thing right there for the Beavers.
Back up to the Oregon 47. Adams has it. He'll pitch it. That's Braylon Addison, who's dragged down by his shirt before he went out of bounds. It's all the way around to the 43 of Oregon State.
Once again, creating a little bit of misdirection, getting the ball out to Braylon Addison, and credit the Oregon State defense. They're going to have to make tackles out in space, because this is what this Oregon offense tries to do.
Quick snap. Adams, can he get away? He does from one and goes out of bounds with a first down. Boy, they don't hesitate. Somebody comes out, they snap the ball. Now, how about the Oregon State defense? Is it usually a 3-3-5? I'm not sure exactly how they're lining up here.
Yeah, once again, the perimeter blocking of the Oregon offense, these receivers getting on guys. And all day long, it'll be on these second level guys for the Oregon State defense to make the plays out in space.
On third down and 10, Adams is going to get rid of it and catch made. What a play to Darren Carrington.
When you get enough pressure and you're able to get in front of Vernon Adams, you've got to bring him down, because those eyes are going to continue to stay downfield. And if he finds open guys, he's shown he has the ability to let it go. But this Oregon State defense has not been able to get pressure on the passer enough this year. And they do it right there. They just got to get him down and not allow him to find guys late in the downs, because these receivers are too dangerous down the field.
Adams 5'11 and 200 pounds, but hung tough to slip that tackle and complete the pass as Griffin carries. It was a gain of 18 and sets him up inside the 15 of Oregon State. Adams, remember, missed three games, most of the loss to Utah due to that broken finger that was suffered in the season opener against Eastern Washington, his old school. Played against Michigan State with the ailing finger. Oregon 2-3 during that stretch. As Griffin carries, and Griffin is in the end zone. Touchdown.
Once again, running the speedy freshman Taj Griffin off tackle. And Seussman from Oregon State was in position. But such a tough guy to tackle out in space, as you see here. They give him a chance to get out in space. Taj Griffin, such a dynamic guy in the open field. Just gives him enough of a stutter step to avoid the tackle and march into the end zone.
Third rushing touchdown of the season. The freshman from Powder Springs, Georgia, after the extra points. And the Ducks behind Taj Griffin this time, lead 14-7. Autzen Stadium, it opened in 1967. Back then, 12,000 seats added. Named after Thomas J. Autzen, who was a Portland lumberman and philanthropist. And the Ducks leading 14-7 now, kicking off. Haskins brought down right away. Remember, without Storm Bars Woods, who it's tough in your last game as a senior, one of the top five rushers in school history, for him not to be dressed for this, that has to be difficult.
It's not only his production, but also his presence on the sideline and on the field for this team. He's a leader, one of the more productive players to ever put on a Beaver uniform. It's tough not to have him out there today.
McMarion under pressure and goes down. The Ducks defense with a sack. Oregon has the lead after the opening quarter of the Civil War. Here in Eugene, we're glad you're watching college football on FS1. Start of the second quarter, Oregon State scored first. The Ducks now with a 14-7 lead. One out of three, McMarion facing a third down and 14. Nall and Bolden in the backfield with him. And that's Bolden on the move at the receiver spot, bottom of your screen. McMarion with a moment. There's a flag down. He is hit hard. Buckner got to him.
He had Victor Bolden down the field with about a 14-yard hook route, but took a monster hit by DeForest Buckner, and that pass was thrown.
Personal foul, illegal hands to the face, number 64. That penalty is declined, fourth down.
DeForest Buckner doing what he's done all year long, getting pressure, wrecking shop in that backfield. And he does just that with the bull rush, throws the offensive lineman aside and makes a clean hit on McMarion.
Buckner at 6'7". Addison standing back at the 40 of Oregon. And backing up to the 30. Trying to get up the sideline and get some of that back. Return up around the 39-yard line after a 51-yard punt. Adams to a wide open Jaylen Brown, who is brought down at the 45-yard line. Vernon Adams coming in, completing over 63% of his throws, more than 2,000 yards, 22 touchdowns. He's also run for a couple of scores. But the touchdowns today have come on the ground from Addison and Griffin. This is Freeman with a big hole. Royce Freeman slips a tackle and gets a first down around the 40 of Oregon State.
When you bring a corner up in cloud coverage like they do here to the field, it's important for those corners to be able to make tackles in space. And that time they were unsuccessful in doing that against Royce Freeman, giving them a first down.
And now Griffin is in, who has a touchdown run. He spins out of a tackle. And there goes Hans Griffin. Out of bounds, it's at the 10.
Great physical run by Taj Griffin, a guy that's only 5'10", 175. You wouldn't expect him to be breaking too many tackles at that size, but he does just that here. Spins out of that one and shows a burst to get up the sideline. Just stepping out of bounds, otherwise that thing goes for six.
Adams 8 out of 13 so far. They picked up 12. Carrington in motion goes to the slot. Freeman's the back. Adams on the move, throws back. An unusual play to Tyler Johnstone, who was the offensive lineman, and Tristan Decoud make the tackle on a weird looking play.
Well, we call this a tackle eligible, getting the senior and the anchor out on the edge, and the idea is to get it with nobody in his way so he can pretty much walk in. But this thing was read well by the Oregon State defense, and as good as Tyler Johnstone is, I don't think we expect him to be breaking any tackles and walking into the end zone.
Well, an excellent defensive play. So a loss of six. I told you this was going to be entertaining. Adams with time, but couldn't find anybody, and he's going to go down. Oregon State with the sack.
This is a, Chris, this is essentially a coverage sack. The Oregon State defense doing a great job of staying on their guys, as you'll see here. Not falling for any misdirection or two-man routes. And there's nowhere for Vernon Adams to go. And he tried to stay on his first, second, and third reads. And they got just enough pass rush at the very end to turn that into a big loss for the Oregon offense.
So they had a first and goal, now backed up. And spreading the field here. Defensive personnel adjustments made for Oregon State. Madison has it, but is not going to get into the end zone. So an important stand for Oregon State.
Well, yep. Braylon Addison sure is going to get his running in over the course of the day. It's amazing how much they do with him pre-snap to try to get him in matchup situations and showcase his versatility.
I think fans thought maybe there was some extra shoving or hitting going on out of bounds there. Devin Chappelle, who is from Springfield, Oregon, nearby, it's practically Eugene, and played at Western Oregon, where he had an interception against Vernon Adams when Adams was at Eastern Washington. He's the one who made the play, and now Schneider to try a 25-yard field goal after missing earlier. He's back on target. The Ducks add three. An ideal fall day for football in the Pacific Northwest. A 12-play drive, almost 5 minutes, wound up scoring a field goal. But that's a big win for Oregon State.
Yeah, as Oregon enters that red zone where they've been incredibly efficient this year, big win for the Oregon State defense to hold them to 3 points. Oregon coming with 17 unanswered points. Time for Oregon State to do something offensively here.
The fans enjoying the fact that the underdog Oregon State Beavers are hanging with the 17th ranked Ducks. The Ducks have won the last 7 meetings head to head in this rivalry. Victor Bolden bringing it out and spins across the 20-yard line. Ryan Nall waiting for the in the backfield with McMarion for the handoff and gets up just short of the 25-yard line.
Yeah, once again, Chris, bringing guys up in this defense to plug these different gaps and either provide pressure if Oregon State elects to pass the ball or stuff gaps in the run game.
Second and 10. McMarion's pass juggled on the sideline but held on to. His tight end, Noah Togiai. Let's take a closer look at the footwork.
It's like that toe barely gets in and secures the ball all the way to the ground. Togiai, a young guy, a 6'4", 215-pound freshman that I feel very good about. He's very explosive. Just want to get him more opportunities.
Collins, a receiver. He's in the slot between the two receivers at the top of your screen. On 3rd and 6. McMarion with plenty of time throws high. And the ball but knocked loose. Victor Bolden had his hands out of a Reggie Daniels.
They're going to end up with 4th and 6. And on that play, Marcus McMarion found Victor Bolden against his own defense. And those holes are tight. That ball has to come quick. And Victor Bolden has to kind of sit in that void. And that time he didn't do that and took a big hit.
Nick Borevsky back to punt. Braylon Addison waiting to receive. Just over 7 minutes to go here in the first half. Fair catch called for at the 27-yard line, and that's where Vernon Adams and the Oregon offense will take over, leading 17-7. When you look at the numbers, and that's with the injuries that we talked about, missing some of the games, playing hurt through some of those, he's a difference maker. Quick pass to Stanford again, who's loose. Stanford is already had quite a few catches in this game.
Here's Dwayne Stanford here running a little tunnel screen, trying to get him in space. It's kind of a compliment to their running game, throwing the ball behind the line of scrimmage, allowing guys to get loose and get downfield with this speed.
21-yard gain, his 5th catch of this game. Adams fires complete. Kirk Merritt again. Kirk Merritt, end zone, touchdown. No, they're going to say he's out of bounds. Hang on. They're saying he's out of bounds inside the 10. There's a flag down as well. And I'm sorry if the shadow's over there. It's a little bit difficult to see.
Holding. Number 73 offense. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down.
Crosby called for the penalty.
Well, just as we referenced this wide receiving corps' ability to block, we get a guy down the field making a holding call, trying to spring Kirk Merritt to get down the field, because this was after the catch, so they're going to get the first down and still get the big play. But as we see here, Vernon Adams with his pinpoint accuracy threads the needle there in the middle of the field for a big play for the Oregon Ducks.
So the penalty backs them up, keeps them out of the end zone. Adams on the move. He's going to keep it and go out of bounds down around the 11-yard line. Might be good enough for another first down, and it is.
A little bit of a balancing act for these receivers too, as we've referenced so many times. As Vernon Adams gets outside the pocket, he has a throw first mentality. Watch these eyes. These eyes stay down the field. He's saying, is anyone open? The receivers have to then make a decision. Do I block or do I look for the football? And that time they spring a block and get him some extra yards.
And Freeman met hard right away. An excellent defensive play. Kyle Pecco's been all over the field today. Number 99 for Oregon State, playing in his last game as a collegian.
Pecco's got a chance to be an impact player at the next level as well. A big guy, 6'1", 200, or excuse me, 305 pounds.
They add up around Thanksgiving.
They do, that's correct. Might have been 300 yesterday, and he's 305 today.
Adams to Royce Freeman. A lot of room to run. But he'll be stopped inside the five.
Once again, Vernon Adams looking down the field, and this time the Oregon State offense, the Oregon State defense buys it, and everyone moves deep on this play. And once that ball is snapped, Royce Freeman leaks out in the flat, and there's just nobody there, leaving way too much room for essentially a blown coverage.
He had a chance having to run the daylight, or in this case sunlight, but it closed up in a hurry with a number of the Oregon State defenders getting over there. So now it's third and goal. Royce Freeman stonewalled and still pushing and shoving. Haven't heard a whistle yet. Touchdown! A delayed response. Somehow he worked his way through the crowd.
Well, Chris, from up here, it appeared that forward progress had stopped, and as you mentioned, we were waiting for that whistle. But apparently down there on the field, those legs of Royce Freeman just keep moving and churning and moving that pile, as you see right here. That pile really never stops, that gradual motion forward.
And with the extra point, the Ducks will have a 24-7 lead. Aiden Schneider, good on extra points, 1 out of 2 on field goals today, and that one is no good. It was blocked. And it got through. Actually, it did get through, even though it was blocked. Okay. Let's take a closer look and give him the points. Hand up, ball through. That was Pecco again, but it's 24-7. And here comes Victor Bolden for the Beavers. Gets up to the 22. Well, the Ducks are celebrating. Washington leads Washington State at the half, 17-3. Oregon would be alone in second in the Pac-12 North if that score stands, and it stands here as Seth Collins is in at quarterback and on the run for Oregon State. Incomplete.
Well, Chris, as you said, if there's implications here beyond just what's going on here on the field today. Bigger picture, Oregon still looks at possibly an at-large bid in one of the New Year's Six Bowls, depending on some success Stanford has late. Are they able to get into a playoff as a two-loss team? It's not out of the question. And also potentially a Fiesta Bowl bid as an at-large team as they continue to impress people in the national spotlight.
Elfrich's team travels well. An exciting offense. It's entertaining as Collins remains the quarterback for Oregon State. He leads this team in rushing. And carries there despite missing time. He has 3 100-yard rushing games, but as you pointed out, Evan, they need to find somebody that can throw the ball downfield.
Yeah, as we know, Oregon State the last few years has had a lot of success as a pro-style attack with quarterback Sean Mannion last year, and they're running an entirely different offense now.
Ryan Nall in the backfield blocking for Collins, who's going to have to keep. It's up across the 25-yard line. Mark Helfrich's team, and he's a native of Oregon. He knows a lot about this Civil War, this rivalry in state. Only 50 miles separating the two schools from Corvallis and Eugene, and the Ducks with the upper hand have won the last seven head-to-head. Nick Paremski punting to Addison, who calls for the fair catch at the 33-yard line. And this Oregon offense, you know, they have an NCAA record streak of 79 consecutive games with a touchdown pass. Looking for their 80th today. They broke the Texas Tech record of 69 straight earlier this year. They don't have a touchdown pass yet.
He desperately wishes he could have Vernon Adams for maybe three more years like he normally would get. Unfortunately, that's not going to be possible, but he is effusive in his praise for the play of Vernon Adams.
And you wonder something we'll talk about in the second half, who's going to be the quarterback next year once Vernon Adams has moved on after his bowl game as Freeman carries to midfield.
But one of the interesting points Scott made is that when Marcus Mariota was here, he played as a young guy, and they went through a period of time where they struggled to get big-time recruits because they knew Marcus Mariota was going to be the starter.
Addison goes out of bounds with a first down catch.
Created a little bit of a void in the recruiting pipeline at this quarterback position. Too many young recruits knew if they came here, they likely would not be playing with a guy like Mariota under center. But now that he's gone, they like what they have here, and they like what they have going forward from a commitment standpoint. The future looks bright.
After a pickup of 13, Adams with time, middle of the field. Addison has it. It's going to be a touchdown, Ducks. And there's your touchdown pass today.
Well, one of the things that's going to happen is you continue to give different looks pre-snap like this Oregon team does with all these weapons and spreading you out, is eventually you're going to start to get some communication errors with the Oregon State defense and some blown coverages. And that finally happened here for the Oregon offense. It's inevitable that they're going to cause teams to get confused pre-snap as they try to account for all the different guys that they have on that side of the ball. And this time, it hurts the Beavers big as they get seven right before the half.
Aiden Schneider on. He has 62 consecutive point afters made despite the last one being blocked by Pecco. It made it through. That one is clean, so 63 in a row for him. And they're clapping over on the Oregon sideline. Our halftime score, Oregon 31, Oregon State 7. Right now, let's head over to our halftime show, the State Farm halftime program with Rob Stone in Los Angeles. Yeah, it's a rivalry game in the Pacific Northwest here in Oregon, but the Ducks try to use it to get to their sixth straight win and their ninth victory of the season. We welcome you back with Evan Moore, Chris Myers, and hope you're enjoying this game here on FS1. And Oregon State will be kicking off to the Ducks. Mark Helfrich said there's a lot in the rivalry. We're not worried about how many points or how, we just want to win the game. We approach everything that way. But you know, beneath the surface, as long as he keep this train rolling, he's happy.
Absolutely. In this game, there's always an emphasis on trying to win impressively, especially right now in the bowl landscape, as we mentioned earlier. There's other implications going on here in the back of these coaches' minds. They know that an impressive win will only help them in getting to the bowl they want to get to, as they have some ground to make up after a 3-3 start this year, and they've done that effectively the last 5 weeks. But it's important for them to get a big impressive win here today, and they're well on their way to accomplishing that here as we enter the third quarter.
There was a stretch between 1998 and 2006 where the home team won every game between these teams. But the last seven in what they call the Civil War up here has belonged to the Oregon Ducks. Checking the statistics from the first half, and we mentioned some of the impressive runs or offensive performances. Adams 17 out of 23, 257 yards. Royce Freeman steady on the ground as always.
Well, the other thing here too, as we mentioned, forcing Marcus McMarion to win the game, this Oregon defense has held him to just 33 yards. And that's really difficult as an offense to move the ball when you don't have the balance. And it's really not like they have a ton of rushing yards either, but they just don't have the balance offensively quite yet. Got to keep the ball out of this Oregon offense's hands, as we've seen them score a ton of points here in the first half.
Royce Freeman on the reception, gets past one defender, and then slips past another. all the way down to the 41 of Oregon State. There's a flag down too. It came late around the midfield mark.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 12 defense. That 15-yard penalty will be enforced from the end of the play for Sam.
It's hard enough to stop this Oregon offense, but when you start giving them penalties after the whistle, it makes it very difficult.
Excuse me, I mean, it's Kendall Hill called for that. And he's in the wrong neighborhood to be doing that. But that's how it goes with this rivalry.
That's some good old-fashioned rivalry pushing going on. Let him play.
Griffin checks him, but Kirk Merritt gets the handoff. And the freshman cut down. There's the ball came out, and Chappelle came up with it. That's Devin Chappelle. It was a tough hit on Merritt.
Well, the safety came up and put a big hit on Kirk Merritt.
Sussman with the hit.
Interesting way he fell, but does his left knee hit the ground? I think that ball is loose.
Yeah, I thought he might have been down, but they're ruling it on the field. Fumble recovery. Seth Collins at quarterback at first down after the fumble recovery. Collins gets up to the 20-yard line.
It's a little bit of a zone read, a new part of this offense that we've seen this year for Oregon State, something they haven't done in the past year for quite a while. Something that was happening earlier this season quite a bit was people playing the read option a little too closely.
That first drive, you talked about it, was impressive by Gary Anderson's team, but since then the Oregon defense tightening up, keeping him out of the end zone. Collins has the only score for Oregon State today on a run. McMarion's pass caught. Jordan Villeman, who had an early catch, hadn't done much since.
Well, as we referenced before the game, Jordan Villeman, a big NFL type receiver, runs a 12-yard hook route, gets up the field. Some of these rhythm throws with Marcus McMarion, I'd like to see them do more of them as the half goes on. It really helps a quarterback's confidence when you get the ball out of his hands to his talented receivers down the field. And that was just a gimme. Guy plays 15 yards off, throw a 12-yard hook. Probably should do a little more of that here in the second half if you're Oregon State.
Ryan Null in motion. Pass is caught and slipping a tackle. It's Villeman again, and there goes Villeman. Down to the 30. Of Oregon.
It's an outstanding job by Marcus McMarion. He ends up getting pressure here, but elects to get rid of the ball quickly like he's supposed to his underneath crossing route. Jordan Villeman puts a couple nice moves on, gets up the field for the first down, but on 3rd and 9, there were longer passes drawn up for that play, but pressure came. It was important to get him the ball quickly and let him get up the field.
Villeman at 6'5". He's from Fontana, California. That's where the Auto Club Speedway is. You can always, of course, see NASCAR on Fox and FS1 throughout the season, beginning in February with the Daytona 500. A gain of 33. This is the best drive for Oregon State since their opening touchdown drive, as Ryan Null gets inside the 15 and gets another Beavers first down.
Really like the things Ryan Null has done so far today. He has one other start this year. We had 122 yards against Colorado, showing a little athleticism there with the hurdle.
You know, he started against Colorado in October, ground out 122 yards, and it was after that game when Gary Anderson, his coach, said, "I want that war daddy wherever I go." Those are the guys I want to recruit, and those are the guys I want to surround myself with. Talking about the toughness of Null, we saw some of that on that run. McMarion hesitates and incomplete. Coverage was good on Hunter Jarman.
Chris, they sing the praises of Ryan Null quite often. He's their workhorse back today. With Storm Woods out of the game, they don't have that guy that's been in the program for a long time to rely on. So the redshirt freshman is getting the call today.
Null at Central Catholic, that's Joey Harrington's alma mater, to its first state title in 60 years back in 2013. And he ran for 22 touchdowns. Ryan all the back on 2nd and 10. Seth Collins hands off, and then they come the other way on the handoff to Bolden, who gets out of bounds.
Once again, disguising Seth Collins, bringing him on the jet sweep, and then going with the reverse to Victor Bolden, who tries to outflank the defense, and he had an offensive lineman out there trying to lay a block for him. But sometimes offensive linemen trying to block secondary guys out in the open field is not a winning combination. They're able to get just enough yards. Make it a third and short here. Try to put this ball in.
It's Null fighting to the goal line. And what an effort to get a first and goal for Oregon State.
A lot of parallels here with how they're using Victor Bolden to create misdirection, creating a little bit of an opening for Null to give that extra effort, try to get the ball over the goal line. But Oregon uses Braylon Addison very similar to the way Victor Bolden is used by this Oregon State offensive staff, and it's very impressive.
So Seth Collins is in at quarterback here, Evan, with Ryan Null. You got to watch where he's going. He's got the football. He leaps into the air, and touchdown, Oregon State.
Well, Chris, we just talked about it before that play. That's the same play they scored on early in the game, creating a little bit of misdirection with Victor Bolden, forcing that defense to widen just enough to create a little bit of a hole. So here comes Victor Bolden, forces that defense to stop their feet, and that time Coleman actually plays it pretty well, but Collins just wills himself into that end zone, leaping up over the top of him and showing that athleticism to reach for the touchdown.
Seth Collins is second touchdown today, seventh rushing touchdown of the season. Garrett Owens with the extra point. Nice halftime adjustment by the Oregon State offense. They drive downfield, and Collins into the end zone. And the Beavers getting on the board here in the second half. A 10-play, 84-yard drive. In fact, their touchdown drives on each of their first possessions to start the game, and then their first possession of this half. That has Gary Anderson applauding. Well, he's a positive guy, regardless of the score or standings, when you talk to him.
Absolutely. It's very clear they have the right guy in the position to build this thing back to all the wins. Oregon State's had a lot of wins over the last decade. Very successful football program, and I think they have the right guy here in place to rebuild this thing back to what it was, possibly even better. As he draws upon his experience at Utah State and rebuilding that program, trying to do the same thing here in Corvallis.
Charles Nelson from the 2-yard line, and hit hard as he gets up near the 29. Did the ball come out? Let's see. And looked like it was loose, but he's back on top of the football, so the Ducks maintain possession. A lot of it because of Adams and Freeman. Royce Freeman all the way inside the 45 of Oregon State. That's now every game he's played more than 100 yards from scrimmage this year.
A little misdirection play, a little counter, getting a good block from the tight end, and a nice little gap to get upfield.
And a quick snap and completion. Charles Nelson, who had the interception. You'd seen him on a return, originally a receiver, comes in on offense. That's how quickly they move. No time to celebrate a big gainer.
Not a whole lot that Charles Nelson doesn't do, and I love the way the coaching staff referred to him. Said his entire chest cavity is just one big heart.
Royce Freeman, the hole closed in a hurry as he is now near 80 yards on the ground and already over 50 yards receiving on 3 catches. You know, he might be a guy with the numbers. You know, you talked about your Heisman candidates and Vernon Adams. I mean, again, leading this Oregon team and rushing. Durable, reliable. Gets the football. Nowhere to go this time. She's knocked back to the 6-yard line. He came in needing only 267 yards in this game and the final game here to beat the school record, rushing record of 1,805 yards by LaMichael James, set back in 2011. Look at his numbers today.
Well, as is usually the case, when you start to lose football games, any Heisman hopefuls you have on your team start to lose some attention. And when they were 3-3,
Royce Freeman was still playing exceptional football, and people just stopped talking about him. But he's continued to do that all year long, and he's worthy of any praise that comes his way from a national standpoint.
Adams keeps. It'll be fourth down.
Was clearly looking to throw on this play. Eyes are downfield. Actually, I take that back. I think that was a designed quarterback draw as his eyes went up.
And the official
came back down.
Caught in the mix, and they're going to go for it. On fourth and goal. What do you expect here, Evan?
I think they're going to get Burton Adams on the move here. Do something with Braylon Addison.
Griffin is the back. Vernon Adams has plenty of time. Can he find anybody? He can run it in if he wants, but he'll throw out of bounds and gets knocked down. Coverage was very good. Ricky Ortiz got in to hit him. Ortiz was a guy who remembers the success of Vernon Adams when he beat Oregon State at Eastern Washington.
With their last touchdown.
Adams has had a hot hand and the upper hand, but on that series, the defense kept him out of the end zone, taking over at the two. The throw way off target. McMarion was trying to go to Victor Bolden.
Chris, the objective here when you're backed up like this in your own territory is to get two first downs. It's called backed up football. It's a situational drill that you always drill throughout the offseason. And they're looking to get at least one, hopefully two first downs. And that's a success to get that field position back, because if they find themselves having to punt in a situation like this, it can make it very tough on their defense to give the Oregon offense the ball in their own territory.
Gets him out of the hole, and it takes three ducks to bring him down across the 15-yard line at a first down.
Such a big sigh of relief for Dave Baldwin, this offensive coordinator, getting Ryan Nall on the move, getting the tight end across and getting a nice cut block. That first down is so critical in this field position battle. So if you don't get this first down, it puts your defense in a really, really tough spot. That's critical yardage, bringing that thing outside the 15-yard line for the Oregon State offense.
Averaging 5 yards a carry against the improving Oregon Ducks defense. Nall as a receiver. And gets up near the 28-yard line. Arion Springs brings him down when they called him, and he gets the first down, the Swiss Army knife. He lines up a tight end, H-back. He's been primarily a running back today.
Well, they're taking advantage of the boundary receiver running that slant route, creating a void out on the outside, and running a little swing route to Ryan Nall for more good yardage for the Oregon State offense.
The redshirt freshman, who has become a favorite of his head coach, called him tough and physical. There's McMarion, who got the start, the third different freshman starting quarterback for Gary Anderson's team this season.
Credit him for seeing Arion Springs manned up to the boundary with the receiver. And that receiver essentially vacated that area, creating a void for the running back to run over to. Delivers a swing route nicely for a nice game.
On first and 10 from the 28. Nall, and there goes Ryan Nall, dragging a tackler all the way down to the 45-yard line. It was Charles Nelson who wouldn't let him go, or Nall might still be running.
It's never good when a running back gets to the secondary, but we just have a little outside zone here. And a great job blocking it up, forcing Charles Nelson to make the tackle, which he was hanging on for dear life on that one.
Helmets flying. Now, Nelson's a guy who had, what, a dozen tackles in one game at that safety spot earlier this year?
Correct, against Washington State. Never good when your safety has that many tackles, because he's more of a pass coverage safety. He's not the type that's going to come down in the box.
Back-breaking penalty. McMarion to throw, and a nice catch inside the 20. Noah Togiai, the tight end, gets a first down.
Another great job of Marcus McMarion being patient. He was trying to work the front side with a Victor Bolden combination with three guys over to the right. patient enough to come back to Togiai, running the shallow cross from the slot route. The big guy, the big explosive guy, delivering that football, allowing him to get up the field. A good job by Marcus McMarion.
A gain of 26 yards, overcoming that penalty. McMarion, pressure coming, has to get rid of it in a hurry. And Rodney Hardrick putting on the heat. The linebacker you talked about, kind of the glue of the defense with the coach's mentality, as a guy on the field who plays that way.
He's really been a big help through any defensive struggles they've had this year. He's a good leader for that defense. And you've been talked about him leading walkthroughs for this defense and bringing these young guys along. He's a great presence and helping this defense get better and improving over the course of the season.
Takes players with him down to the 10. 6'2", and he's running like he's bigger than that. And carrying that 255 frame. He'll bring up third down and 4. Oregon State has, on third down, converted 3 times out of 7. There's Seth Collins back in, who has the 2 touchdowns for the Beavers.
One of the things that's worked really well when Collins is in the game is moving Victor Bolden around pre-snap. They've done it with McMarion in the game as well, but it's been even more effective when Collins is in the game because of his athleticism.
Collins to run, cuts back for the end zone. Touchdown, Oregon State. Ball came out at the end, but ruled a touchdown right away. And of course, they'll review it to be sure. But what an alert move. Slicing through the Oregon defense to get to the end zone.
And I love the way offensive coordinator Dave Baldwin elects to stretch the field out in the stretch formation. And all he's trying to do is run that off tackle, but sees a nice little cutback lane and cuts it up the middle and shows his athleticism. The idea is to stretch that play, but he sees a cutback. He's got great vision, the instincts of a running back, and puts that thing in the end zone.
And the extra point is good. 7 career starts for the true freshman. Missed the last 4 games, returning this week in style. Seth Collins with his 3rd touchdown today. Well, he didn't start at quarterback, but Seth Collins putting on a show, Evan. That drive, 98 yards, covering 9 plays, and he's in the end zone for the 3rd time today.
Yeah, we're seeing his ability to play several different positions. Spent most of the week playing wide receiver. They just see him as their best athlete, and they have to find a way to get him on the field as long as he's healthy. If it's not going to be quarterback, it's going to be somewhere else. He's been a huge asset for him today.
Charles Nelson on the return, slips a tackle. Nelson still going. Brought down from behind, a good saving tackle by Garrett Owens, the kicker. A return of 41 yards.
Well, Charles Nelson, such a dynamic player in the kick return game. Had a big return versus Stanford Cardinal just 2 weeks ago. It was a big game-changing play in that game. But you see his ability once he's in space to turn on the accelerator, and he does that really effectively here. Such a special player for this Oregon team. Fills so many different roles for them. And this one giving him great field position to start this drive.
The sophomore from Seabreeze High School in Daytona Beach, Florida. And has an interception today. He's also a member of the Oregon track team, a sprinter and long jumper. Showed you some of that ability right there. From the 45 of Oregon. Vernon Adams throws on the run and completes. Evan Bayless is tight end, has a first down, spotted inside the 45 of Oregon State, and down at the 44, a gain of a dozen. Adams in the pocket, underneath to Griffin, and he gets knocked down around the 22-yard line. Over 500 yards of offense for the Oregon Ducks, with still a quarter to go. They've been averaging again 43 points a game during this 5-game win streak. It's Addison who slips out of the tackle but then three more Oregon State defenders are there, including DeCoud and Jonathan Willis.
It's an outstanding job by DeCoud recognizing what they're trying to do on the bubble screen. And as that ball gets thrown out there, he blows up the guy trying to block him. Ultimately assists on the tackle, missed the lead tackle, but is able to keep him back where he was. It's a great job sniffing that play out and being physical by the corner.
Gary Anderson talking to some of his defensive players. Griffin remains the back after a 12-yard loss. A one-handed grab over there by Taz Griffin. He's near a first down. The freshman who's a backup to Royce Freeman and Kenai Benoit.
It's the design screen route. He becomes a first option in that as the receivers were blocking for him. The ball's designed to go out to Taj Griffin immediately after the ball snapped and get him out in space. He effectively gets up the field on that one. But once again, great job blocking by the Oregon receivers. Something they've been accustomed to doing in both the passing and the run game.
And Evan, they're going to go on fourth and a yard. Remember they went last time on fourth and goal from the two and did not score. Hand off Freeman, and he'll score! A 19-yard touchdown run for Royce Freeman, his second of the day.
Well, Chris, you said it. They got in position very quickly to go for it on fourth and one. And I think Oregon State might have caught itself out of position a little bit. Probably could have used a timeout to make sure they were in the right front. Tyler Johnstone gets away with a little bit there with his right hand, creating just too much separation for enough to make a hole. Big play on fourth and one.
A lot going out of the trenches. Aiden Schneider with another successful extra point. Freeman with the run.
Well, as we see here, they elected to give it their feature back, and we have a hole right here that was created maybe by a little bit of a hole by Tyler Johnstone. He was able to get away with it there, create some space for his running back. Once again, when Royce Freeman gets that head of steam going forward, it's difficult to stop him. And he's pretty good as it is, but when you don't get a hand on him, a little too easy for him. Well, it's exciting to watch these running backs do their thing, both Freeman, Griffin, James, Benoit, all of them. They don't even have Thomas Tyner on the field, a guy that's still out, been out for the entire season.
Victor Bolden with a spin and thrown down at the 36. A nifty return. Oregon State has scored two touchdowns here in the second half. Ryan Nall on the reception. He is not easy to bring down. He has battled today. And that is the end of three. FS1 College Football presented by K Jewelers. On second and three for Oregon State. Null gets the first down and a lot more. Inside the 45. I wouldn't make that up, Evan. Of course, he was a duck back in the early 70s. Terrific announcer, outstanding quarterback for the Chargers. Normally, he would be smiling at a toga, but that might have. There you go. There's. We just showed you the mascot, Betty the Beaver, and the duck enjoying this matchup. Here's Null, and nowhere to go. And the Ducks swarm him. DeForest Buckner, part of the crowd.
I really like what they're doing here with Ryan Nall in the second half, but this time Oregon answers the call. DeForest Buckner coming off his block, making a big play and essentially running into the wall of the Oregon defensive line. Trying to put the clamps on Ryan Nall. He's had a good second half, and a guy we knew was going to be the featured back today, as indicated by the coaches all week long. And he's a big back that they can rely on. But that time, it's a good job by the Oregon defense.
It'll be second and 15. Chris Brown in at running back now. Nall catching his breath. Incomplete through the hands of Seth Collins. Looked like he had a shot at it with Charles Nelson running with him.
Well, Chris, that was a matchup play.
There's a flag down too. Evan, it came in a little bit late. See here.
After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct, taunting number 26 defense. 15-yard penalty. That's an automatic first down. That's a first unsportsmanlike conduct foul for number 26.
Khalil Oliver, the freshman, called for that penalty, Evan, and that's Nelson there running with him on the coverage.
It was a matchup play, trying to isolate Seth Collins on Charles Nelson. Throwing a go route on him, a nice ball. I thought Charles Nelson got there a little early.
Here's Ryan Nall. Knocked out at the 20.
Let's go back to the unsportsmanlike penalty. At the end of the play, Khalil Oliver comes over, gets in the face of Seth Collins. That is absolutely taunting, and it's something Mark Helfrich usually does not tolerate.
And
that's a big penalty.
You played the game. I mean, it's a rivalry. There's emotion. But the reason coaches don't want that and officials, it just leads to further activity that is not healthy and not about the game of football and sportsmanship. So some people say, oh, come on. Well, that's the reason the call. Now second and 11. Marcus McMarion right on target. Jordan Villeman down inside the 6-yard line where it'll be first and goal for Oregon State.
Well, I love the call. Oregon electing to play a version of cover three. And Jordan Villeman just running the three-step slant route, getting up the field. The linebacker is widened by the flat route out of the backfield, creating a nice little void for McMarion to deliver the football to his big receiver on the slant. It's a very effective route against that kind of coverage. Results in a first down for the Oregon State offense.
McMarion is in for the touchdown. Seth Collins has three today, and the freshman quarterback keeps for his first today.
Once again, using the motion of Victor Bolden pre-snap to create a little bit of misdirection, and it's a design keep for the quarterback. It was well blocked on the front side. Victor Bolden creating that misdirection, well blocked on that front side. He's got a barrage of guys out in front of him and just walks into the end zone. Well executed by the Beaver offense.
Garrett Owens, the extra point. McMarion, after the pass completion to set up the run, keeps it himself for the Beavers' touchdown. The scoring drive is McMarion, the freshman quarterback, with his first career rushing touchdown. He had one touchdown pass coming in. 8 out of 16, 120 yards through the air. And it's only a 10-point game with an onside kick, but it didn't go far enough. And the Ducks will take over. A little frustration because they might have been able, Evan, to catch him off guard a little there. Adams with time. And now he goes down. It's Kyle Pecco with a sack.
Well, Kyle Pecco, a difference maker on this defensive front for the Oregon State Beavers. And he just pushes his way through, and Vernon Adams has to hold onto that ball a little longer than he would have liked. But Kyle Pecco putting on full display why he's a guy that the coaches have enjoyed coaching so much since they got here. He's a reliable guy and battles every snap. He's a guy you have to account for, and that time makes a big play for this defense.
Can Oregon State, after the failed onside kick, keep this offense from gaining? Adams on the move and goes out around midfield. It'll be third down.
Big stop by the defense if they can hold him here.
Griffin a tailback. Adams throws wide open but bounces the ball to Nelson. And he knew he had him open. He's frustrated. Missed that opportunity. But the penalties hurt him here. And the Oregon State defense forces a fourth down and long. So here comes the punting unit for the Ducks.
Well, this is a huge win for this Oregon State defense. A game-changing type stop. With a 10-point lead, the Oregon offense is unable to do anything after recovering that what was an attempt at an onside kick. but such a big stop for this Oregon State defense as they're going to get the ball back down 10 points.
And Blake Mimone is coming in. Looks like to punt. I think that Matt Logan. And Victor Bolden is loose. Victor Bolden with a punt return touchdown. 78 yards.
Well, you never know how this stuff's going to come back to get you. Their punter, Ian Wheeler, has been out sick, not available today. And this punt just does not get enough hang time. It ends up in Victor Bolden's hands way too soon. And they're unable to have their protection or their coverage team down there to make a tackle. And he makes them pay with that speed. A leader for this offense, not so much verbally, but more by example, makes a huge play to make this a one-score game.
Well, they hadn't had to punt today as the extra point goes through. Matt Logan had never punted in a game before. And between the punt and the speed of Bolden, the underdog Oregon State Beavers have battled back. And in the Civil War, they're only down three. The punter, Matt Logan, forced into duty because Ian Wheeler, the regular punter for the Ducks, was ill. They hadn't punted all day. And then Bolden took advantage for his first career punt return for a touchdown.
Well, as we mentioned, we just don't get enough hang time on this punt. And in textbook fashion, you get white shirts all over green shirts. And this is how it's done, allowing Victor Bolden space to get up the field, up the gut of the punt coverage team. And he's off to the races for a big score for this Oregon State football team.
Pass caught right away. Carrington is tackled by Decoud. And this would be, I know Oregon has the football and the lead, Evan Moore, but this would be a colossal upset in this rivalry if Oregon State could somehow pull this off.
Oh, we knew going into this is a rivalry game. A lot of people thought they had this figured out, how this thing was going to turn out, but people inside the state of Oregon really realize what's at stake here. You trust this Oregon State Beaver team is going to show up. You're a 3-point game with 9 minutes left.
Charles Nelson with a first down run. We mentioned coming in, the Ducks have won the last 7 in this series. You know, here at Autzen Stadium, we mentioned Animal House. This was one of the filming locations for the movie Animal House, and it'll turn into that. There is a crazy upset. Right now, the Ducks doing what they do, moving with the football, trying to protect their string in this rivalry. 8:40 to go. Facing 2nd and 4. Complete to Carrington, who gets the first down and goes out of bounds. Vernon Adams over 320 yards passing. Freeman over 120 yards rushing today.
Chris, you said it, just an amazing turn of events. I think after Oregon recovers that onside kick, it looked like this Oregon State team was in trouble. Credit them for putting us in this situation here. Oregon's responding well and moving this football right now.
Griffin, and Kosh Griffin gets inside the 5.
As we've seen several times today, getting Kosh Griffin on the jet sweep, and a jet sweep is always going to have to rely on these receivers down the field blocking, which you see from Darren Carrington right there, creating just enough space for him to get outside. You have speed like Kosh Griffin, all you got to do is give him one extra step and he's going to get those yards for you. A big day for Taj, 10.3 yard average on the ground. Very impressive.
An 18 yard run, and he remains in. Adams, end zone, catch made. Touchdown, Braylon Addison. His 3rd of the day for the Ducks.
Well, they attempt to sell the run action before the play, and the backside receiver Braylon Addison sells the crossfield route, puts his foot in the ground, and comes back to the corner. And after Vernon Adams keeps that ball off the play action, he finds his receiver wide open. This play action here is important to the flow of the play. Then he comes right back and finds his receiver in the corner of the end zone. It's a well-designed play. And the timing of it is perfect. His receiver's wide open in the corner of the end zone for a touchdown.
Schneider on for the extra point. And it's back to a 10-point Oregon lead. So the punt return, and this is how the Ducks respond. Adams has his team out in front by 10.
Well, Chris, as referenced earlier, this last play for the touchdown is a well-designed play. It relies on the play action that creates the facade. They're going this way. This receiver's going to come down for a cutoff block and come right back to the corner of the end zone. Fake well carried out by Vernon Adams, and he just comes back and finds Braylon Addison right over in the corner of the end zone. Very, very well-designed play by Scott Frost, the offensive coordinator.
It'll be a touchback, second touchdown pass of the game for Vernon Adams. He now has 24. Marcus McMarion, complete right at the first down marker to Victor Bolden, who had the punt return moments ago of 78 yards. So much more at stake when you talk about the bigger picture of bowl game for Oregon, ranked 17th. Oregon State trying to win with Gary Anderson, first year head coach, their first Pac-12 game of the season. Ryan Nall with a big hole. Can he go all the way? Ryan Nall, outstanding with a touchdown. 66 yards. The freshman from the neighborhood.
Well, we've seen the big bruising back quite a bit today, and he's able to put his speed on full display. As you see here, just a void created in the middle by the tight end coming across, and a missed tackle there by 56. But Ryan Nall showing his speed down the field. Been a difference maker today for the Oregon State offense.
It's back to a three-point game. 19 carries for Nall, 174 yards, and this, a 66-yard touchdown dash. No team has ever scored 42 points and lost a Civil War game. This is the 119th meeting between these two.
Well, let's go back to the touchdown. They elect to bring the safety down towards the line of scrimmage, creating a void in the middle of the field. And this linebacker here, Rodney Hardrick, gets out of position just enough to leave an even bigger void for Ryan Nall to explode through the middle. And there is nobody to get their hands on him, and he shows his speed for a big run and a big play to get Oregon State back in this football game.
A short kick, Charles Nelson. And he goes all the way up to the 48-yard line. Ducks will take over, protecting the three-point advantage. Let's take a look at our Ford game summary. Amazingly, starting, it's worth repeating, their third different freshman quarterback this season for Oregon State. Just a two-win team hanging with Oregon that's going for a sixth straight victory. Seth Collins with three touchdown runs for Oregon State. Royce Freeman has two and has the football. To the 46 of Oregon State, Jonathan Willis coming up to make the tackle. The last game in Eugene in 2013, epic. The lead changed six times after halftime. Oregon won 36-35 when Marcus Mariota had to throw a winning touchdown with 29 seconds left. As Freeman gets loose and gets inside the 30 for a first down.
Well, as we're starting to see when this game goes on, it's the effect that Royce Freeman has on the opposition. They got to start wrapping up. As this game goes on, the defense gets tired, and the arm tackles just aren't going to get it done for this Oregon State defense. You've got to wrap a guy like that up.
Hands off, Griffin, knocked down for a loss. Kendall Hill from his spot, the defensive secondary.
Kendall Hill's a great example of some of the position changes they've implemented here for this Oregon State team. Gary Anderson came in, identified talent in different areas, and said, hold on here, let's move guys around and make sure we're taking advantage of their athletic ability and their skill set. Kendall Hill there, you saw a former wide receiver and safety now playing corner, makes a great play on that tackle in the backfield.
Adams, all kinds of time. Yeah. Open end zone, touchdown Ducks! It's Addison again. Braylon Addison with his fourth touchdown of the day.
Well, once again, Chris, this offensive line is playing as well as any unit in the country, and they give Vernon Adams just enough time to keep those eyes down the field. And we've drawn parallels, if, for those of you out there watching, we've drawn parallels to Russell Wilson quite often off camera relating to Vernon Adams. His ability to move around but see downfield just like Russell Wilson does at the next level. And he does it so effectively and makes it such an asset for this offense.
Vernon Adams wears that number three just like Russell Wilson wears three for the defending NFC champion Seattle Seahawks. Coming off a 6-touchdown pass performance, Vernon Adams has three today. Back to a 10-point Oregon lead. Good protection for Vernon Adams in that drive to respond for Gary Helfrich after the Oregon State team narrowed it down to three once again. First year in Oregon for Vernon Adams, but already a win over Oregon State. Remember, he led Eastern Washington to a win over the Beavers in Corvallis in 2013. Had four touchdown passes in that game. And Victor Bolden, they're not going to give him a chance, so that's a touchback. From the 25, McMarion, there's a little trickery. And there's Nall with the catch. Seth Collins on the throw, and he has a first down up there midfield. Kind of like what we saw in that opening drive where they got everybody involved.
That's the other dangerous element. When you bring the double pass out, you bring another quarterback on the field, you know he has the ability to throw. The receiver does a good job clearing out that space for Ryan Nall, then fills that void, and Seth Collins delivers the ball nicely. Just another weapon of his that's on display.
A pickup of 24. McMarion open. He's got another first down. It's Bolden fighting hard to get to the 37 and a half yard line of Oregon.
Impressive element of McMarion's game today is rarely has he forced throws. He's put his team in a good position. He's taking what the defense gives him. Other than maybe one or two throws in the first half, he really hasn't forced throws, which is something you don't see young quarterbacks pull off very often, but he's done a nice job of that and allowed them to move this thing down the field as part of this overall push.
Time, but he held it too long. It's Buckner with the sack.
Well, unfortunately, on that play, they bring Victor Bolden in a short motion, which is a big indicator that they're going to run some kind of crossing route with him. And they do that, and I thought Marcus had plenty of time. But as you'll see here from this high end zone look, he has time to find, watch, just in the middle of your screen, Victor Bolden come open there. And if he puts that thing on him as soon as that window opens, that's a big gain. He was unable to identify him. With that zone coverage, there becomes a nice little window there to deliver the ball. Missed opportunity there for the Oregon State offense.
Oh, the growing pains of a freshman in a rivalry game. It'll be third down. I want to go back to DeForest Buckner, one of the players you identified at the start of the game, Evan, the senior who leads this Oregon team in sacks. He has been a force all afternoon.
And he's a special player here on senior night, trying to make his presence felt. But he and a couple other guys up front are the reason they've been able to get better as a defense over the course of the season. The push they create has allowed them to get a little more creative on the back end and become a better secondary. But give these guys credit up front, and it starts with DeForest Buckner.
Ball underneath, but short of the first down, goes out of bounds. Reggie Daniels not allowing him to get inside the 30 where they needed to get. So on fourth down, let's see how they play it.
Well, it's a smart play by Marcus McMarion, as they knew this was four down territory, and the Oregon defense elected to push this thing way back and play deep coverage. Take what they give you, start to chip away at it, and now you find yourself in a 4th and 7, which is somewhat manageable.
You could opt for a field goal and then try the onside kick, but they're going for the first down. Marcus McMarion in the hands and out of the hands of Victor Boldum.
Yeah, it's a good play call, well-designed play. He had Victor Boldum over the middle of the field. This thing just comes out a little bit low. Certainly a catchable ball by Victor Boldum. If he brings that in, that's a first down. That's a tough drop.
And he knew it, excuse me, Evan, and so did McMarion, the frustration. What an effort from Boldum and McMarion today with just over 2 minutes to play.
Well, over the course of the week, Dave Baldwin referenced some of the layups, so to speak, that they've missed over the course of the season. And although it was a little bit low, that ball was in the chest of Victor Boldum. Probably should have been caught. That would probably classify as one of the layups that they've missed over the course of the season.
And now the Ducks going for the slam dunk and try and put an end to the pesky Oregon State Beavers, who have hung tough. Well, you said, Evan, in a rivalry game, anything can happen. Just over a minute to play. And Freeman will be brought down as the clock continues to run. This Civil War history between Oregon and Oregon State, the second most points in the series. Remember how far back this goes, to 1894 when it first began, the 119th meeting. And Oregon, Mark Alford saying, let's finish this thing up. It'll be the 8th straight win for the Ducks in the series head to head. Vernon Adams victory formation with 366 yards passing and 3 touchdowns. And he said, hey, I wouldn't change anything. I don't regret all the moves, the injury, 6 straight wins, 674 yards of total offense. And the Ducks will roll into the postseason after a battle with their rival Oregon State Beavers.
I don't know if there's a guy in this conference, in this Pac-12 conference, more deserving of Coach of the Year than Mark Helfrich. What an outstanding job to finish this season that he's done.
With Evan Moore, I'm Chris Myers, our entire crew. College football on FS1 continues with Rob Stone back in Los Angeles coming up after the break.